In addition, we are taking further steps to educate our clinical teams on our critical care triage protocol.
What happens when there are more ICU patients than ICU beds? Alberta hospital staff may soon be staring down that life and death decision. That's why Alberta Health Services is training workers on this triage protocol to determine which patients get priority for life-saving care.
One of them will get it, the other won't get it, and the consequences will be significant. They may instead get more palliative treatments.
The 52-page triage document provides a lengthy checklist, but it ultimately comes down to which patient has the highest survival rate.
Factors like age are taken into account. Of course, your comorbidities are taken into account.
The document includes exclusion criteria, a list of medical conditions that could decide who gets critical care. And while it does not differentiate between those who are vaccinated and those who are not,
it is possible that we could see some clinical evidence that two people were otherwise in completely equal states of health and one was vaccinated and one wasn't, that perhaps the vaccinated person would be assessed as having more potential to benefit from that treatment.
The document is also considered rigid, ensuring criteria is the same province-wide. And who makes that final call? Not attending doctors, but a team of other medical experts.
That makes separation between the treating professionals and those making decisions. And so those decisions are being made outside of the context of the doctor-patient relationship.
This is not unlike emergency room triage, where heart attacks are usually treated over an injured hand. But given the life and death drama, the ethical implications are much heavier.
Does this devalue the lives of certain people who have disabilities? If we have two people, we're really just reducing them to these medical conditions. And I think those are difficult kind of ethical questions to ask.
Scott Frolic, City News, Edmonton.